Hi, my name is George Pearson, and this special Photoshop Elements video is part of a series that I have on doing photography techniques for wedding photography. You can see a few examples in here from the different videos. Now, all of these are using images that are available free on the internet, and I have a link in the description for you to download the videos if you want to work with the same images that I'm using in my video demonstrations. Please subscribe, click the like button, and of course always share on Facebook, Twitter, or wherever. I really appreciate that. Okay, let's go ahead and get started with the video. In this Photoshop Elements wedding photography project, I'm going to be showing you how to do this stacked Polaroid effect. Now, it looks really interesting. It's pretty easy to do, pretty straightforward, and this particular technique gives you a lot of freedom. I can move around these individual elements, I can resize things, I can change things any way I want. Nothing is locked in, I'm not doing any cutting in here. It's all using clipping masks, as you can see, to make this whole thing work. It gives me a lot of flexibility. Okay, let's now see how this whole project is done. I'm just going to get this out of the way here, and we're going to open up my original file on this. And that's that picture right there. Just a nice little wedding picture. Let me enlarge the size and we'll zoom in so we can see this. There we go. It's just about full size. You can see, there we are. You can see the top and the bottom of the picture in there. And there's our image. This will be the basic image for all of the effects. Now, I want to have my main picture right around like that. And we can eyeball that by bringing in the guidelines. Just pull the guidelines in from the rulers here. I'll be doing the outside of this first. We can resize it later, which we'll do. This gives me a basic frame. So about like that is about right for the basic frame. Let's make a new layer. There we go. And let's revert the colors, inverse the colors, so that white is the foreground color. Go up here to the rectangular marquee tool, and let's pull a marquee down just to match those guidelines. There it is. Let's now fill that with white. So paint bucket and fill. There we go. Okay, we can deselect. Let's now pull the guidelines in a little bit, and I'll use these to visualize where the frame is going to be for the Polaroid. And a little white at the bottom. There we go. So that's our basic frame. Now I'm going to be cutting out this middle section right in there. Same thing as before. Go to the rectangular marquee, follow the guidelines. This time hit the delete key and delete that center section, and let's just deselect that. Now that I have that, I can reposition this a little bit, resize it a little bit until I'm happy with the look. I think that looks pretty good. Choose OK. So now I have that. We're done with those guidelines. We can get rid of the guidelines now. So view and clear guides, they're out of the way. Now we're going to be doing four copies of this frame, and we'll be repositioning those copies on the page. Those will give us our stacked Polaroids. So take this one and drag it up here to the new layer button. There's our copy. I'm going to pull that one up. Let's come just outside the corner here. I'll rotate this one around a little bit, and I'll get a nice big overlap in there, in behind that foreground picture. It's a nice little overlap on that. Choose OK. Back to the original layer. Pull that up. Let's lift this one up here. I'll rotate the opposite direction this time, just outside of the corner. Little rotation, and let me just find a spot. Oh, kind of like in here somewhere. So this has some different overlaps happening, interesting overlaps. Maybe a little further out like that. Choose OK. Gives us some interesting little triangles in there. All right, let's come back to our original layer. Drag that up here again. This time let's pull this down lower left-hand corner, and I'll rotate this one that way. And I'll just bring this one out here somewhere. Just kind of drop it down to the bottom of the page. Choose OK. And then one more copy. Drag it at the top. Pull it down here. Let's go just outside the corner, and let's rotate this one around something kind of like that. I want to have it, you know, a different angle from the other ones. In here somewhere, and I'll just bring that over like that. Maybe let's show his whole foot down there. And choose OK. So there's the different images. And that's all set. Now I want to have this original layer on the top of the stack, so just pull it to the top. There we go. That's our first step, first phase here. The next phase is I want to fill the centers of all of these with black, but on new layers. I'm going to show you what I mean by that. We're on layer one, grab the magic wand tool, click inside. That selects that transparent area in the middle of this layer. Let's make a new layer. Invert the colors so black is your foreground color. Paint bucket and fill. So there's the white frame. New layer above, which is black, fitting inside that white area. Okay, deselect. We'll do the exact same thing for these four layers. Come down one layer, that's upper left-hand corner. Magic wand, click inside. New layer, paint bucket, fill with black. And deselect. Then our next one right here, this is upper right-hand corner. Same thing, magic wand, click inside. New layer, paint bucket, fill with black. And deselect. Okay, our next one is right down here. This is the bottom left-hand corner. Same thing, magic wand, click inside, new layer, paint bucket, fill with black, and deselect. One more. That's our bottom right-hand corner right here. Magic wand, click inside, new layer, paint bucket, fill with black, and deselect. Okay, that step is now done. Now, I want to take the background, make copies of the background. I want to have a copy of the background above each one of these black layers. So let's take our background copy, drag it up to the new layer button like that. There it is, just drag that above the black layer. I can now copy this layer. There we go. Drag it above the black layer. Copy this layer, drag it above the black layer. And just keep on moving up this way. Copy this layer, drag it above the black layer. Copy this layer, drag it above the black layer. So we have these stacks now. Picture, black layer, frame. Picture, black layer, frame. Just double check all of these. Picture, black layer, frame. Picture, black layer, frame. Same thing, picture, black layer, frame. And the background in behind. I can now hide that background. Okay, now, let's move up to the top again. We're going to be taking these and putting these into the black as a clipping mask. Two ways to do this, two ways to get to it. One way is layer and create clipping mask. Puts it inside of that frame. There it is. The other way is to go here, right-click, and do the same thing from the right-click menu. There we go, that's the easiest way. Back to our next layer down, right click, create clipping mask, there we go. Next one, right click, create clipping mask. Next one, right click, create clipping mask. And there it is, there is all those images all nicely masked out. Now we have nothing in the background, so let's put a background in here. Go to the background layer, let's make a new layer above the background layer. Go over to our gradient. I'll leave the gradient at the foreground to background, which is our default. And I'll drag from over here down to over there. So just like that, just a little gradient in the background. Okay, there's the basic image. Now, a couple of things. First, if you want to move an image around, you want to move the frame around, grab the frame and the black layer together. You can then move the frame around, and notice how the picture is still there. Picture is, you know, totally available, so you can move this anywhere you want to and get your framing exactly right. That's the beauty of this particular technique, is this ability to come in and modify after the fact. So there's my good position. If you want to move the picture inside with the frame, just select that as well, so they're all selected, and then the whole thing moves. So there we go, that is the flexibility. Okay, the last thing I want to do is to put a drop shadow on this frame. So here's our layer one. That's the white frame layer. Layer, layer style, style settings. Let's give it a drop shadow. And I'll move the lighting angle upper left-hand corner, which will put our shadow on the right and bottom. Let's bring the distance out so you can see it. There's the shadow right there. I'll bring it out about that far. Bring the size up a little bit. The size softens the edge. So the distance is how far out the shadow is going, and the size is how soft the shadow is. Right about there. Just gives me a little bit of separation in there. Choose OK. Let's now copy this shadow onto the rest of those frames. So right click, copy layer style. Let's come down to the next frame. Here it is. Right click, paste layer style. Let's come down to the next frame. There we go. Right click, paste layer style. And come down here. Right click, paste layer style. And then the bottom one, right click and paste layer style. They all have the nice drop shadows on them. And there we go. There's the stacked Polaroid look. Now, one little thing, if you want to move one of these pieces that's over or cutting off on the edge, you want to move that in. Keep in mind, that's this one right here. There we go. Keep in mind that you don't have this layer mask all the way out. So if I tried to move these two, you see what happens where I lose my layer mask on that side. So if you want to move one of these outer edge ones, you can move it the other direction, no problem. You can move it out here, no problem. If you pull it in, you begin to see where that layer mask hasn't finished working. So you need to just recreate that one layer. So remove that layer, move your frame where you want it, and then redo your layer mask. Now you can do that by just clicking on your layer mask, right click, and release the clipping mask. Then hide that layer. Come down to this layer. Just delete that layer, trash can. Come back to your frame layer. You can now reposition your frame where you want it. I'll put it right there. So you can reposition your frame. And then come back and do the same trick as before. Magic wand, click inside. New layer, black as foreground, paint bucket, and fill with the black paint. Then deselect, back up to the image above that layer, right click and create clipping mask. And there we go, we've now repositioned that and redone that clipping mask. It's that easy to redo this whole thing. Again, that's the beauty of this technique, is that it's completely adjustable after you have done this. Nothing is locked in place. Gives you complete freedom to make this Polaroid effect. So there we go. That is how to do the stacked Polaroid effect here inside of Photoshop Elements. Thank you for watching this special Photoshop photography project video. Don't forget to subscribe so that you will get first notice of new project videos in the future. Just click on this link right here where it says subscribe here. You can get all 12 project videos in this series, along with 26 special videos demonstrating the tools and techniques that I used in these projects by clicking on this link right down here. And then thank you again for watching this training video.